Good morning. I'm Susan Pertnoy. Welcome to Mosaic, Jewish Federation of Palm Beach County's weekly news magazine show. Mosaic explores Jewish topics here in the Palm Beaches and around the world. The median age of Jewish community members in the Palm Beaches is 65, the highest in the country. Thousands of seniors in our local community, many of whom are frail and living in isolation, are looking to live with comfort, companionship, and independence. On this episode of Mosaic, we'll explore how our Jewish community is innovating how we care for frail seniors with Dr. Alan Sadowski. We'll then speak with participants of the Enhanced Companion Program, which is enabling seniors in our community to age in place with dignity. And then we'll talk to Keith Myers, President and CEO of Morse Life Health System, about new and exciting developments for seniors in our community. We'll be right back with Mosaic.
From empowering Jewish college students to stand up to anti-Israel activity on campus, to enabling seniors and Holocaust survivors to age with dignity, transforming, inspiring, saving, Jewish Federation of Palm Beach County is doing all of this here and around the world.
They say that caring for the elderly is a profession of the heart. As the director of home health care at Morse Life, I know that to be true. When I see an older person feeling safe and secure at home, I know I've done my job. To make a difference, to show compassion, dignity, and respect, it's not just our job, it's our mission.
Morse Life Home Healthcare.
Morse Life Health System, honoring senior living.
Welcome, Alan Sadowski. We're pleased to have you. You are the Senior Vice President of Morse Healthcare Services and Executive Director of Kramer Services. Is that correct, or
yes.
I missed something?
No, Morse Life Health Systems and Kramer Senior Services. So,
which makes you in charge of everything off campus?
Yes, well, in a nutshell, my job is to help people to not have to live on the campus. And over the years, in the last decade or so, more and more people prefer to stay at home and age gracefully and independently. And so we've been bringing services to them, and we've been bringing more and more services to them as more and more people live at home and age in place in their own residence.
So what is unique, what about Morse in terms of Jewish seniors?
Well, the Jewish community has some unique features. Number one, the quickest growing age segment of the Jewish senior population is the 85 plus population. And the average age of the people who live on campus is in the 90s.
Oh,
the average age of the people that we serve in our home care division is in the mid 80s. And that has increasingly grown. I've been here about 18 years, and we've seen those numbers ratchet up. The other interesting piece about the demographics is that more and more of our seniors are living here alone without family members. So it's a little bit different than in the Northeast corridor where, you know, seniors have their children around and their grandchildren around, and sometimes they move in with their family members. We see more isolation here in South Florida than we do in the Northeast.
So how does a senior reach out to you?
Well, there's lots of ways that they reach out to us. We have all kinds of 800 numbers that they can call. We have our ear to the ground and our pulse on the community heartbeat in terms of what is needed. And we keep expanding our services. It's very important for us in terms of our mission that as people age and they become increasingly isolated, that they don't have to give up their Jewish traditions. So, for example, if a senior loses the ability to drive or shouldn't be driving,
right,
we help them celebrate holidays with our mitzvah program. We bring the full meal to them, and they don't have to worry about cooking, shopping, and preparing. We do a lot of things to make sure that, you know, we have sent buses to kosher butchers and things like that, so that our aging senior population can continue to embrace the traditions that they remember from their, you know, entire life before they were seniors.
And that sounds like it's just such a wonderful opportunity for them to actually even engage with the people that come to the homes.
Yeah, and it is, and it's also, from my perspective, a very satisfying profession to be in, because we get that immediate reward of knowing that we're helping people, knowing that we're able to coordinate a doctor's visit or help care for someone who has lost some of their activities of daily living, prepare a meal, give them a bath visit. We have a new program, relatively new in the last couple of years, called PACE.
Yes, that's actually very extraordinary. Will you talk about that?
Sure. PACE is an acronym that stands for Program All-Inclusive Care for the Elderly. And we have the exclusive PACE program in Palm Beach County, which means no one else can do that. And these are people who are more than 55 years old, although, in all honesty, we don't see 55-year-olds. These are people who meet the criteria to be in a nursing home. The state has determined that they can live in a nursing home, but they choose to stay at home. And so we essentially bring the services to them. Every morning we have a meeting with our interdisciplinary team with like 9 or 10 different disciplines. And we do extensive care planning. We look at things like their nutrition, their family needs, their medication. And through a concerted effort, we're able to keep people from going to the hospital. If they do go to the hospital, we get them out much more quickly. And sometimes they can come to Morse for a short period of time. And we're doing everything we can to help them continue to live in the community.
I see you have buses all over the community.
Yeah.
And is that, you're transporting people for programs? Don't you have wonderful schedules for?
We have very sophisticated software. I thought I was like an administrator of a program. I think I'm in the van business. And we actually have some grants from the Department of Transportation. And we've not done a lot of advertising about PACE. Our biggest advertisement is very happy clients and our buses that are all over town. We have a fleet of, I believe it's over 20 vans that go all over the county.
And don't you now offer opportunities in Delray at a second location?
Yes, this is a particular interest in the Jewish community because our program here was reaching capacity and we needed to expand. And so we contacted a synagogue in Delray, and synagogues tend to not be very busy during the day. So we have a long-term lease arrangement with Temple Sinai in Delray, and during the day it's a PACE program, and on Sunday it's a Sunday school, and we have a wonderful working relationship with them. And we're actually thinking about repeating this model and concept as we expand to yet a third site sometime in the next year or so.
Well, that's a wonderful opportunity for our senior population. What motivated you to get into this field?
Well, a lot of people don't choose to get into the field of caring for seniors. And when I first came here, we were talking earlier, I had friends saying, going to work at Morse, isn't that going to be depressing? Isn't it a place where people go to that great beyond? And I can tell you, in the 18 years that I've been here, the culture here is extremely upbeat. I sometimes have to close my door when we have our shows because the singing is too loud. The campus is filled with very dedicated professionals who feel that they are right there at that moment when someone is needed. And so it's very rewarding. It's very satisfying. We're helping families. We're helping seniors and all the people that are connected to them. And it has been a complete joy to have been associated with this organization. And hopefully for years to come.
Well, you definitely improve the quality of life.
Thank you.
So it's wonderful that they have you here. Thank you for the opportunity to have spoken to you.
Thank you, and you're very welcome.
Coming up, we'll speak with participants of the Enhanced Companion Program, which is enabling seniors in our community to age in place with dignity.
The patients who come to us after illness or injury are often in pain and fearful of losing their independence. I make it my mission to treat them like family. I listen to their concerns. I help them heal and gain strength. My goal is for them to not need us. To know that I help them, there's no better feeling.
Morse Life Short-Term Rehabilitation.
Morse Life Health System, honoring senior living.
We're here with Donnie Greenblatt, director of the Enhanced Companion Program for Albert Jewish Family and Children's Services, and Janet Klein, who is a volunteer for the Companion Program. Welcome.
Thank you.
To
Thank
Mosaic.
You. Happy to be here. Thank you.
I'm glad to have you with us.
Thank you.
Donnie, tell us about the program.
The Enhanced Companion Program is we send our companions. Our companion is a specially trained senior volunteer, and their role is to provide assistance to other seniors in the community. They can provide assistance with transportation to medical appointments, transportation and assistance with errands, as well as we could provide caregiver support and companionship and socialization to seniors in their homes.
Why do you find a need for this?
Many of our seniors that we find lose the ability to drive. Once they lose their ability to drive, what typically happens is they become shut in and they become socially isolated because they can't get out and they can't get their own needs met in terms of shopping, medical appointments, or socialization. So sending in a senior volunteer to provide that assistance with companionship and socialization, as well as to get their concrete needs met of transportation to medical appointments and shopping and errands, really enhances their quality of life and decreases their social isolation and increases their level of functioning, their ability to live better in the community.
How do you train these volunteers?
These volunteers are trained with a 40-hour training course that we go through, where we talk about specific issues in terms of aging process and the assistance that they might need and clients that they might encounter and what assistance they could provide, what assistance they cannot provide, what their boundaries are, what the limitations are, and what kind of services they're going to need to help other seniors in the community.
I'm sure they're also your eyes and ears if there are issues with the people that they're visiting.
Correct, yes. A great benefit to the program is that a loved one who either in-state or even out-of-state knows that they have someone coming in on a weekly or twice-a-week basis to be their eyes and ears from Jewish Family and Children's Services, and they report back to myself and to the other case managers, and to know that their loved one's needs are being met, and anything, if there is a need that's out there, it's reported to us, and we do our best to fill that need for them.
That's wonderful. Janet, tell us about an experience as a volunteer.
An experience as a volunteer.
What do you do, for example?
Well, okay. Right now I have four ladies that I see every week, and they run the age gamut from age 62 on up to 99.
Wow.
And each one of them has different needs. One of them is blind. One of them, being 99 years old, obviously it cannot drive, go anywhere, and so forth. But the thing is, all four of them still like to live independently. They do not want to go into an independent living or an assisted living program. And right now they're fortunate enough not to have to do that. However, what we provide, we take them to medical appointments, we take them to supermarket, we drive them wherever they want to go, but we also do provide companionship. I was with my 99-year-old yesterday, and I pull up to her house. Now, I go right into her house. Okay, where are we going today? She has to go somewhere. We go to the card store, we go to the park and walk around, and she loves it, and she just loves the couple of hours that I can give her just to talk.
No, I'm sure.
To be able to express herself and have somebody, just a good listener. You know, this is basically what we do.
But I would imagine it's very important to keep that consistency, and you have to commit to showing up, because they tend to really look forward to your visit, and
yes.
It would be very disruptive if you didn't commit.
But what happens is you become close with them. You become their friend. They rely on you for a lot of things, and it's not only for driving them here and there. They rely on you to be a companion to them, to sit down with a cup of tea and let them talk and tell you all about their past lives and everything, because they do have amazing stories to tell. Most of them have been around during the Second World War and the Depression and everything, and I find this fascinating to hear about their experiences. Their families came over from Eastern Europe, from Russia, during the pogroms and everything. And it's a learning experience for me as well.
I'm sure it is. The Albert Jewish Family and Children's Services takes care of a lot of the Holocaust survivors.
Yes.
Do you provide companion care for many of them?
Yes, a lot of the Holocaust survivors do have their companion care as Janet said, for the assistance with socialization and assistance with transportation, companionship.
A very unique group.
Somebody they could really share. And that's also part of the training as well, that our companions are trained you know, with dealing with Holocaust survivors and Holocaust care, how, when they work with them in their homes.
But just for the time commitment alone, how do you select these volunteers?
We're looking for a great question. Thank you. We're looking for active retirees who want to give back. They want to pass on their legacy. They've worked, you know, all their life, and now they're tired of playing canasta or mahjong or golf or tennis, and they want to do something productive now in this second stage of their life. So I think it's a win-win situation for both the clients that we serve and the companions and the individuals that become companions, because they feel fulfilled and feel like they have now another purpose in life, and they could pass on their legacy and want to give back to the community.
It has to be very gratifying, because a lot of the seniors down here still have their families up north. So
yes.
You or your service is really their only connection. They become so isolated otherwise.
It is such a great service. It provides that respite, that comfort, that peace of mind to family members that live out of town, that live up north. They know that someone's coming in to provide the assistance to them and get their needs met. And it gives them comfort and peace of mind.
That's wonderful. Yeah. Janet, why did you decide to become a companion?
Why did I? I don't really know. I mean, it was offered. You know, my husband and I both do this. We were looking for something to do, and we wanted to give back to the community a bit, you know. And we got in touch through the Alpert Jewish Family and Children's Services with this program. They gave us wonderful training.
I'm sure we do.
I mean, we've had the experience of the CPR and an intensive training, and to recognize problems that might be manifested in some of our clients as well, so that we can report our feelings, you know, to Donnie or Donna, whatever, you know, and say, hey, I think there's a problem going on here, you know. So we're trained to recognize these things. We also do respite care, because some of our clients are still living with their caregiver, whether it's their husband or a daughter or a sister, and it gives the caregiver a chance to get out on their own.
Which is very, you know, critical.
Very important, you know.
Yes.
It gives them a break as well. You know, and it's a nice thing, you know.
So how do the seniors in the community, because find out about your services? How do you advertise?
We advertise in newspapers by word of mouth, by people know that if someone has an issue, they know to call the local Jewish Family and Children's Services, the local Jewish Social Service Agency. So they could call Ferd and Gladys Alpert Jewish Family and Children's Services at 561-684-1991. And when the person answers the phone, just say, I'm interested in getting a companion and becoming part of the companion program.
It's just a big need, and you're really fulfilling it in such a wonderful way. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you for joining us.
Thank you for having me.
Coming up, we'll talk to Keith Myers, President and CEO of Morse Life Health System, about new and exciting developments for seniors in our community.
From empowering Jewish college students to stand up to anti-Israel activity on campus, to enabling seniors and Holocaust survivors to age with dignity, transforming, inspiring, saving, Jewish Federation of Palm Beach County is doing all of this here and around the world.
Hello, I'm standing here with the president and CEO of the Morse Life Health System. You are amazing. This place is amazing. Who lives here?
Well, Barbara, thank you so much for coming, because we're very proud of what has been occurring at Morse Life. Right now, we have over 550 residents that live on our campus. And with the opening of our Levin Tower, we will have over 800 people that will be living here come August of 2017.
800 people? My goodness, the service you have to give them. How do you get people that take care of 800 people properly?
Well, we're very fortunate, because we have over 2,500 employees that work for Morse Life. We believe in the importance of education, and we constantly improve our employees by giving them the appropriate skill sets that they need to ensure that they can care for our residents in the most appropriate way. When you look at the campus, we have not only short-term rehab, long-term care, We have memory care, assisted living, independent living now. So it's a lot to take care of, but we're very proud because it's something that this community has come to expect from our Morse Life Health System.
You know something, you've made a remarkable change. I mean, I was involved with this Morse from the time it was just begun, literally. And when they hired you, you transformed this place like overnight. I mean, look at this place. First of all, you're building something. You were talking about the Levin Center. It's right over here, isn't it?
Right, the Levin Tower. It's 182 units of independent living. You know, in South Florida, there's such a demand for luxury independent living. And through the board of directors, working with our management staff, we decided to make the Levin Tower the most luxurious independent living residence in all of South Florida. Because people will come to rent here, and when they come, they're going to expect services and the type of amenities such as concierge, gourmet food, spacious apartments. They're going to want activities. And what's very nice about being on the Morse Life campus is that they have a safety net because of the other services that we provide here on our campus, which is the health care services, such as short-term rehab, memory care, and long-term care.
You know something, it's so remarkable. I mean, we have a country filled with senior citizens, literally. And nobody seems to have a formula, much like you have here at the Morse, that really is successful. They don't make them independent. They don't make them feel secure about themselves. They don't know what to do with themselves after 60 or 65. So the wonderful thing that you've done is so satisfying, isn't it?
We're just very pleased because not only do we have very large and great facilities that we're taking care of people who live on the campus, but we have a very large home and community-based services. So anybody who is living on this campus or in the community can take advantage of our home and community-based services, such as our home care program, mm-hmm. our skilled home care program, our care management program. And do you know that any given year we serve over 50,000 meals from our Meals and Wheels program to the entire community?
Community. I mean, you deliver it during the holiday.
Yes, we have through our mitzvah program, through Rosh Hashanah and Passover. We send over 3,000 meals to homebound seniors in the community.
Yeah, what makes this senior environment different than any other in the area? Is there anything else that really can compare to it?
Well, I'm very proud that one thing that is very successful for us is that we have a strong partnership with the board of directors. And the board of,
directors
that work here.
Yeah.
And they have helped us create new services and services that this community has come to need and expect. And this helps us to evolve. And as we continue to evolve and adapt to the changes in the healthcare arena, we build new services that is needed for this community. So we constantly continue to push the envelope to the next level, so we strive for excellence in everything that we do.
You know, I was going to ask you that because there's always an opportunity for a future. You know, places that service people, that take care of people, there's always the next step up. I mean, what are you going to do next after this beautiful Petra Levin gorgeous building?
Right. After Stephen and Petra Levin building has opened in August of 2017, our goal is that we will buy additional land and build other buildings that will serve other needs within the community. One thing about Morse Life is that when there is a gap in the community of a service that may be needed, we rise to the occasion and we find out how to make it happen and we open it. For example, 2 years ago, we knew that there wasn't the type of Alzheimer's care, dementia care that really that our Jewish community would really accept. So working with our board of directors, we started to look at what was the best type of memory care program out there. And we took one of the oldest buildings on campus, we reconfigured the space, and we took a 120-bed nursing home and made it into a 52-unit assisted living for memory-impaired residents and added 30 new nursing home beds for dementia care. And now today, I have to tell you that Morse Life, through our memory care program, is leading the charge for excellence in providing Alzheimer's cares. And now people throughout the country are calling us to get our formula as it comes to providing Alzheimer's and dementia care. And this is just an example how we respond to gaps in our community and then how we roll it out to make sure that we are providing excellence to our community.
Well, you've done such a remarkable job. Just tell me briefly, what directed you into this kind of profession?
Oh, well, that's a very good question. I can tell you that one of the first jobs I had as a child, or really as a teen, was working in a nursing home. And from that point on, I fell in love with working with seniors. And when I'm helping and providing care and making sure that the seniors of our community are being cared for in the appropriate fashion, it reminds me of my grandparents, of my parents, and other people that I've had a long relationship with. And I wanted to make sure that they will always be cared for in the most appropriate fashion. You know, you have to think about it. In the Jewish tradition, the mitzvah of caring for the father and mother is a foundation. And I can tell you here at Morse Life, it is definitely what we utilize as we build all our services and make them operationalized.
Well, you have done a remarkable job. You really have. I have to congratulate you. Really, you've done it. It's so beautiful. It's a pleasure to come here. Thank you.
Well, we thank you very much for coming, Barbara, as usual.
Coming up, final thoughts on Mosaic.
Thousands of community members come together through programs and services provided by Federation and our local partner agencies to create a vibrant and vital community in Palm Beach County. Together, we can ensure a vibrant Jewish future. Federation and you, changing the world together.
I hope you enjoyed this morning's episode on how our community is caring for Jewish seniors. You can watch today's episode and all past episodes of Mosaic on Jewish Federation of Palm Beach County's website. Visit jewishpalmbeach.org/mosaic. Join us for a very special episode of Mosaic next Sunday morning at 10:30 a.m. here on WPTV News Channel 5. We'll be sitting down with renowned journalist David Gregory for an in-depth discussion on his unlikely spiritual journey and the unique role it's played in his life and career. For now, have a great week and goodbye from Mosaic.